basically I thought of preparing once when your so Ramesh Kumar has said, I thought of introducing to you about normalization and query optimization. These are the two things that I have prepared. But if you have any further doubts, maybe we'll take it. Is it okay?
Yes,
not just for namesake you should be sitting here. You should actively involve yourself. My face will be known to you for the next 1 hour. That's it. Isn't it? So you should show your active face. Just keep smiling. That's it. Is that okay?
Yeah.
What have you understood from normalization? Once when the term said normalization, what have you understood? Why is this required? Why is this normalization required for a database? Okay. Reducing a complex table into subtables. Complex table into subtables. So that it will be easier for you to process. Right? Even when, once when said, you have a question for, you prepare for an examination, you've got an answer for about 7 to 8 pages, right? You will take out only key features of that 7 to 8 pages. You will draft it as a 16 mark question initially, right? When it is asked for 2 mark question, you will convert that into 2 mark question. What is essentially required or what is to be written on for 2 mark question, you will convert it, right? So, necessitating for all these initiatives would be a normalization. But then, you will have a lot of anomalies in that. Are you exposed to the word of anomaly? Anomaly? Yes? Yes? What do you mean by anomaly? What do you mean by anomalous behavior? Or exceptional behavior? Isn't it? Anomaly. What do you mean by that? Something, you might be right or wrong. Errors, right? Any common name between two people sitting here? Sindhil Kumar, Prabhagar, Venkatesh. Venkatesh seems to be a quite common name, isn't it? Venkatesh, quite common name. When I'm working for higher level of databases, these things that we do are not simply for the student database that we are about to create, the library management system that we are going to work with, right? These are something to be done with larger systems. When we work on larger systems, there need to be effective changes on it. Okay? Say for example, as they have mentioned Venkatesh, it's quite common name. If you look at this college itself, how many Venkatesh should have been there? All these 4 years combined together in the same college, roughly about 10-15 students with the same name, right? For that reason, if I start inserting all the values to one Venkatesh itself, Venkatesh cannot be in fourth year, Venkatesh cannot be in third year, Venkatesh cannot be, same Venkatesh cannot be second and first years. Isn't it? All four Venkatesh are different. Abhinna Modala Kamani. Right? One record that is to be inserted for one Venkatesh should not be inserted for other. So I'll check for some constraints. What would be my constraints? Say for example, I am inserting a record which should be for a subject called database management system that cannot be inserted for a 5 year student. Isn't it? The assessment report for Venkatesh who is studying third semester of IT department cannot be inserted for Venkatesh who is studying in fourth year. The assessment marks will never tally. This DBMS is not there in the final year, isn't it? So likewise, I'll list out a list of values which seems to be anomalously behaviouring, right? There should be some behaviour. We call it as vandalism sometimes. Vandalism and another one. How many of you don't understand Tamil? Sometimes we use a word called vandalism. It is something like whatever I did. Disturb to the third properties or third person's property, whatever disturbances that I create, not to my own property, somebody else's property, that is called vandalism. See, I see this pillar, right? This is looking too good. What I initially did is a white t-shirt, right? It's a white t-shirt. Venkatesh, third semester, B. Enakke theriyama intentionally,
then start writing that.
Isn't it? That is called vandalism. This is supposed to be my abnormal activity, anomalous behavior that I try to do with something. Likewise, to a database, if I try to insert some anomalous values like this, what will be the impact? That is supposed to be your normalization stuff, right? Another example to better explain about this normalization, right? Say for example, we take out all the records at CEG campus. I'm just telling you, CEG campus, we have three batches of computer science students. We take three batches of computer science students: G batch, or AB batch, CD batch, EF batch. Each batch has a strength of 70 students, say. 70 students, right? For a particular batch, if I am to assign for third semester database management system, after evaluating the complete list of papers, after the end semester examination, right? You look at the list of students who have been admitted initially during the first year, be around 180 students, 210 students are. Just stop me if you cannot follow. I would have admitted 210 students initially, isn't it? 70 plus 70 plus 70 of three batches. Okay? All these students come from the same mark. The difference of marks would be very less, isn't it? Even here and there will be some students who would have been admitted by consortium quota, industry quota, something like that, but that will be a meager percentage. Apart from that, if I take all the students, they would have scored more than 197 and above out of 200 in the first class, isn't it? 197 to 200 doesn't make much of difference, isn't it? Amava Ilya. Yes, right? So I have undergone a course for three different batches of G, H and I, or A, B, C, D and E, F, right? For those reasons, I cannot claim batch AB has scored 90% as an average, batch B has scored only 60% as an average, batch EF has scored 75% as an average. That cannot happen. Different. That cannot happen. Can it happen? It cannot happen. Right? For those reasons, I cannot evaluate the entire scripts again. Because evaluating 210 scripts, how much time does it take? For every paper, it might take 10 minutes. Evaluating 210 scripts, how much time it would take? 2,100 minutes, which is approximately equal to? Ethna hours? Ethna hours of man effort? Rappa chulunga. Mental calculation is at most required. In mental calculate panna theriyala appadina solla, it is very difficult. Odane mobile eduthu calculator on panni podu. 2100 divided by 60, which is approximately
3
hours. Itna hours? 44 digits solla 40 hours ah 40 hours irma approximately, so 35 hours. 35 hours is equal to working days. Working days, no? Per hour, I will work only for 8 hours. Right? How many working days? 6 working days. Isn't it? 6 working days, I may have to put in my effort again to evaluate 210 scripts. Which seems to be too much of my work. Isn't it? For those reasons, what I'll do? I will tend to normalize these values without affecting majorly. Right? If I start evaluating the entire scripts after having looked at the average of all three classes, my intention would be what? Class A, B ki average 19 baat hai. Class B, C ki average 16 baat hai. Class E, F ki 75 baat hai. Right? After having looked at all three averages, Will I touch AB's paper? They've got very good marks. Let us not disturb that. Will I be able to evaluate BC's batch or CD batch's paper? CD batch's paper? Will I evaluate CD by this paper? No. We are the one who has scored less, isn't it? Least 60 marks. So, when I did the armature, I had a impact. I did the bullet. They have scored 19. These people have scored only 16. So, put more marks. அப்படி இருந்ததா இன்டென்ஷன் இருக்குமே தவிர என்னோட இன்டென்ஷன் அப்படி இருக்காது என்ன எழுதிருக்கானோ அது மார்க் ஒன்றும் இருக்காது ஸோ ஐ டோன்ட் டேக் அப் ஃபார் நெக்ஸ்ட் வேல்யூவேஷன் ஸோ வாட் ஷுட் ஐ டூ இஸ் ஐ ஹேவ் டு நார்மலைஸ் ரைட் ஃபார் நார்மலைசேஷன் ஆல்சோ ஐ வில் நாட் கோ பியாண்ட் சர்டன் லிமிட் ஃபார் நார்மலைசேஷன் ஆல்சோ ஐ வில் நாட் கோ பியாண்ட் சர்டன் லிமிட் ஓகே வாட் ஐ டூ இஸ் ஐ டேக் அப் 60 ஐ டேக் அப் 90, what is the average between these two? What is the difference between these two? 30 marks. Right? How can this be lower? Because all three faculties are different. I can justify saying my class average is 90 purely because my students have outperformed. My students have outperformed in our justification. 60 says even my students are too good, but I have evaluated tough. Strict valuation, so I wish to increase more. So, Lava, in the justification in Lava, the 30 difference every match for round is 90 can go beyond to certain level, saying 90, it can go up to a threshold of 0.9. I have to decrease it by 0.9. Okay? So, 90 into 0.9, how much it will be? 9 into 9, 81. Correct? So 8.1 marks of 90 can be reduced. So how much it will be now? 81.9. Right? So people who have got exactly 90 would now score 81.9 because of this multiplication factor. I include some multiplication factor because of this. I say 81.9 would be their new mark. People who have scored 100 out of 100 would now score only 91.9 marks. Right? Not by re-evaluating but by re-justifying. Okay? And I say the lower bound who have been getting 60 marks, I have to boost them up, isn't it? That is the objective. I have to boost them up. I say 60 multiplied by 1.1. How much can I really increase to? 66. Isn't it? 6.6 marks can be included. So people who have got 60 now will be called 66.6. These two are agreeable? Even though this range seems to be too heavy. Right? There is a slight difference of marks. Now that I have lowered the top end range and I have increased on the bottommost. So this can be pretty much accepted. That, but then this gap of 30 won't be there in any evaluation. I'm just exaggerating. Right? But what would really affect us? Any difference more than 30. Right? Those are based out of assessments. We have looked at the past history and we have taken an analysis by where we have plotted saying any average difference which is more than 30 need to go for multiplication factor where we may have to normalize. சரியா ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி தான் உங்களுடைய நார்மலைசேஷன் கான்செப்ட் வந்துச்சு இந்த நார்மலைசேஷனுடைய பேசிக் ரீசன் என்ன அப்படின்னு கேட்டோம்னா ரைட் ஐ லுக் அட் அ கிறிஸ்டல் நவ் தட் ஐ ட்ரா திஸ் கிறிஸ்டல் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் டு திஸ் இமிடியேட்லி இட் பிரேக்ஸ் நவ் ஐ டேக் அ பீஸ் ஆஃப் அவர் ஐ ஷோ இட் டு யூ வாட் யூ சே அபவுட் திஸ் பீஸ் நவ் of a crystal, but if it had, I would have shown it before to you, only this piece of a crystal, you would have said this as a crystal, isn't it? So that is how we are going to work on relations. I'm replacing this word of crystal into relations. Our relation is broken down into multiple relations. A crystal is broken down into multiple crystals. Likewise, a relation is broken down into multiple relations to avoid two basic things. To avoid two basic things. What are those? You would have studied about that. To avoid two basic things. What are those? Redundancy. Redundancy. What does it mean by redundancy? Duplicating operator. Right? Data duplication. Which is very vital in today's world. Right? I look at my history where the first machine that I procured was only with 4GB hard disk. First machine which I procured was only 4GB hard disk. I did not find any difficulty in locating particular file in that 4GB hard disk. But today, every machine that you tend to get carries a minimum of 100GB, 1 terabyte, 100GB, more than 100GB, isn't it? 500GB to 1 terabyte would be a machine configuration. Other than that, you will not appreciate it as a machine. Isn't it? If I have 500GB, have you got sufficient information for storing entire 500GB? 500GB store pannunga sonna neenga enna store pannuvinga ரெண்டு போய் பெட்டர் எடுத்துக்கிட்டு போய் 32GB படம் முதல்ல காவி பண்ணுறது கரெக்டா மூவிஸ் தான் காவி பண்ணும் மற்றபடிக்கு நீங்க டெக்னிக்கலா இன்ஜினியரிங் கிராபிக்ஸ் புக்கு வாங்குங்க இது புக்கு வாங்குங்க அப்படின்னு சொன்னா உங்களுக்கு வேலையே இல்லையா That will never work, isn't it? So what we are acquainted of doing is, we will not be able to store one file once. We will be able to store it multiple times at multiple drives, multiple folders, which is one problem, right? To eliminate those, we work with normal issues. So to avoid redundancies, and to avoid anomalies too. Anomalies, the real problem, so now I will give you an example. Venkatesh, what is the date of birth? Venkatesh, you think it's enough. Because recently you got the question. 31-7-1997, our date of birth. So yeah, 31-7-1997, Venkatesh was born. But if I have to automate the entire system, right? If I have to automate the entire system, having given the birth certificate of Venkatesh, right? My birth certificate records will be entered not on 31 itself. Instead, it will be entered on 1st of August. 1st August 1997 would be my entering day, isn't it? The same day I will not be able to enter my records, isn't it? And you might later put the numbers for this one. So yeah, for those reasons I cannot insert all the values at 1151 itself. I am inserting on 1st August 1997. That does not mean he is born on 1st August. Am I right? But I enter another date which says he is born on 31st July 1997, but his data is entered on 1st August. So I should have 2 days. Isn't it? One is the date in which I enter, the other becomes the date which is actually true. This is called a valid date, and this one becomes your transaction date. This is called a valid date, this becomes right. For these reasons, I cannot predict and say that 31st is the birth date of Venkatesh. I cannot say I have entered all these details on 30th July itself. Then it becomes anomaly. Right? So that is how I detect all these anomalies and say that you reduce redundancy, you reduce all these anomalies. Go up all these things so that it works better. Right? And if you look at really how today's company work, they are not typically bothered about redundant approaches. But they are bothered about anomalous behavior, but they are not really dependent on redundancy. Because we have huge volume of data. We are talking about cloud computing, plug and play type of services, isn't it? We are not really bothered about having too much of information, but then we are bothered about correctness of the information. So anomalous is not appreciated. Only the nature of redundancy is taken, not appreciated. Taken. Correct? So that's what we study about normalization. But have you read normalization before? You have studied. Then what should I do then? As she pointed out, you have any doubts on that? Yeah? Normalization is very important as far as examination point of view is concerned. Now, the question paper is there. Sariya? So, I do another thing. If really, you have a question about it, you have a question about it. I'll do one more thing. I'll take up query optimization. If you feel that particular session is interesting, then I'll continue with normal session, or else I'll leave. Is that okay? So yeah. So we'll go with query optimization. Yeah. What do you mean by this query optimization? Optimization and other.
Yes.
Enhancement.
In what way? In what sense?
Best way to get
an
output.
Best way to get an output. Right? You have been routinely doing a lot of activities at home, from the morning, early morning, whatever work that you tend to do, right? Now that I want you to optimize your time, right? In the stage of life left, enjoyment is the time you can go. If you leave, you will say, you will study. எந்த ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸோட போகலாம், எங்க எங்கெல்லாம் போகலாம், இதுதான் ஆக்டிவிட்டியா மனசு கரெக்டா. அதை நான் என்ன சொல்றேன், as you grow up gradually, where I have to reduce that in an efficient manner, right? First year it is not a problem, second year it is not a problem, third year it is slightly a problem, and fourth year it is totally a problem, because roaming around will never give you a good result, isn't it? If you don't have a good result, you will never end up in a good career, isn't it? So you will start thinking slowly. அப்ப திங்க் பண்ணாலே ஃபர்ஸ்ட் எதுக்கு ஒரு ஞாபகம் வரும், முதல்ல நான் என்ஜாய் பண்ண டைமை குறைக்கணும். அப்போ எங்க எஃபெக்டிவா குறைக்கலாம், படம் பார்க்கறதுனால குறைக்க முடியாது. ஸோ அந்த 3 hours இருக்கட்டும், என் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸோட நான் ஊர் சுத்தத்தை குறைச்சிக்கலாம், திங்க் பண்றீங்க இல்லையா? That's called optimization. Best effort put to minimize your work. Okay, to minimize your work. Have you undergone this course? Query optimization for the exam? Yes. எல்லாமே படிச்சுட்டு அவனு பாத்துருக்கீங்க, நல்ல ஒரு மாதிரி. The same slides? Not yet, isn't it? Okay, then I'll tell you small facts. If you are feeling very comfortable, let me know, maybe we'll continue with something else. I think last unit you have surprise classes of here. லாஸ்ட் யூனிட் என்ன, 50 யூனிட் சிலபஸ் பார்த்துக்கோமா? அட்வான்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஃபிக்ஸ்ட் டேட்டாபேஸ் ஐ கேன் ஈவன் டிஸ்கஸ். இஃப் இட் இஸ் நாட் கம்ஃபர்டபிள் டு யூ, ஐ கேன் ஈவன் டிஸ்கஸ் ஆன் தட். எனிதிங் இன் தி சிலபஸ், ரைட்? பட் ஐ டெல் யூ வாட் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி இஸ் ஆப்டிமைசேஷன். மேபி திஸ் இஸ் ரிஸ்க் அப்ரோச். ஓகே, ஹேவ் யூ சீன் திஸ்? I am just simply giving you a query, very simple query. List all managers who work for sales department is my query. List all managers who work for sales department. Right? So, how do you create a table first? How many tables should have been created for this? How many tables should exist for this? What do you want to do? Employee, what do you want to do? Employee or table, department or table. I wanted managers of this employee table and I wanted who works for a particular department, sales department in the second. Right, in a very joint query. Okay, every joint manalam. I am writing a SQL query for it. I'm writing a simple SQL query for it. Is my query right? Select star from employee comma department, where, where, employee department number should be equal to department, department number, which is very common. Till now I have not looked at any manager or sales department or something. And I'm checking for another concept which says employee's job should be equal to manager, and employee's designation should be
sales.
Sorry, department name should be
sales.
Is it alright? How do you think my system will understand on this particular query and process? Type on it. ऑपरेटर्स What are those? Sigma is for what?
Select.
Project.
Union.
Intersection. Join. Set difference. Cartesian product. This will in turn convert all these English statements, natural language statements, into a canonical format. Machine understandable format. ASCII codes are padike pogudhu but my MySQL software will need to understand things not by natural language but by canonical format. Canonical format is just converting natural language into sigma type or pi type or Cartesian product type and so on. Right? So how would I effectively represent on this particular query? How would I represent on this query? Is this okay? What I have in this? What is the symbol for? Cartesian product. Employee Cartesian product of department. From the table that I am trying to retrieve, I am checking for these three constraints. Will it retrieve me the result? Yes? Are there any other formats of writing the same? Or is it the only format? Are there any other ways of writing it? Yes? Then what are these? I have converted my natural language. Select I replaced by sigma. I have looked at the constraints I have used there. Right? I have used AND to replace it, I have used UNION, right? I want from this table, so I used Cartesian product. What else is the difference? Where is the difference required? Where can be the difference? Is the only way of doing it? Yes? No, no, but you are not sure. Yes, it's okay, comfortable. I do it in another format where I say I check for a constraint, isn't it? Employee's department number should be equal to department's department number. So I do an equi-join where I try to combine employee and department. It does the same operation as it is done by Cartesian product. Cartesian product enna pannu? I take one row from the first table, I try to multiply with all the records of second table, isn't it? Thereby I create a new table, isn't it? What does my new join do? It checks for the condition of employee's department number is equal to department's department number. It will try to retrieve only those files. What is the difference between the previous query and the present query? Where does the difference lie?
It does create a new table.
Previously I have created more records. Before I wish to retrieve the actual format of the data, actual output of the data, I have created more records. But right now I am taking one specific constraint, I am checking for that constraint, I am retrieving something. Right? Something like this. I see two different records. I see two different records. This is supposed to be employee, that is supposed to be department. ரெண்டு இடத்துல இருந்து நல்ல புள்ள வாங்கன்னு சொல்றேன். யாராவது ஒரு நல்ல புள்ள ரெண்டு ரெக்கார்ட்ல இருந்து வாங்கன்னு சொல்றேன். அதுக்கு யாராவது சொல்றீங்களா? வர முடியுமா? நீங்க அந்த என்ன கேசிங்க? நல்ல புள்ளனா யார் சார்? சரியா? நல்ல CGPA வச்சிருக்காங்க நல்ல புள்ள. என்னோட அசம்ஷன். ஐ அம் an academician. நல்ல மார்க் கன்சிஸ்டண்டா ஒரு மார்க் வச்சிருக்கவங்க முதல்ல ஏஞ்சுவாங்கன்னு சொல்றேன். அந்த கண்டிஷன் தான் நான் செக் பண்றேன். Employees department number is equal to department number. People who have got more than 8.5, please come. First you can sit up. இவங்களாம் நல்ல பிள்ளை, நல்லா படிக்கிற பசங்க, நல்ல பிள்ளை, சரியா? இது மாதிரி வச்சிருக்கவங்க முதல்ல வாங்கன்னு சொல்லி. Is that the only way of doing it? Question கேட்டா நோ 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 சார், ஆனால் பதில் போட்டு சொல்ல மாட்டேன். Is this the only way of doing it? Processing the first record and processing the second record, which one is quite comfortable for you? Second one is feeling feasible for you and comfortable for you, isn't it? Why? Because you could reduce time. That's a basic assumption, isn't it? I'm writing in another format where I say, from employee I'm supposed to retrieve only manager. In the pakkathula 8.5 mattum vechirukavanga mattum vaanga. அந்த பக்கத்துலேருந்து 8.5 வச்சிருக்கவங்க மட்டும் வாங்க. நவ் தட் ஐ ட்ரை டு கம்பைன் தீஸ் டூ பீப்புள் அண்ட் சி வெதர் ஹூ இஸ் குட் ஆர் பேட், ரைட், ஆஸ் பர் மை கன்ஸ்ட்ரெயின்ட். ஸோ வாட் ஐ டூ ஃப்ரம் எம்ப்ளாயி, ஐ எம் டேக்கிங் அவுட் ஒன்லி மேனேஜர்ஸ் பிகாஸ் மை குவரி ஆஸ் ஒன்லி ஃபார் மேனேஜர்ஸ். லிஸ்ட் ஆல் மேனேஜர்ஸ், மை குவரி ஆஸ் ஃபார் ஒன்லி மேனேஜர்ஸ். அட் தி அதர் சைட் ஐ எம் லுக்கிங் ஃபார் ஒன்லி சேல்ஸ் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட். ஸோ ஃப்ரம் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஐ எம் லுக்கிங் அவுட் ஒன்லி ஃபார் sales. Select name is equal to sales from department table. Select job is equal to manager for from employee table. Now that you combine these two based out of this condition. Right? Of these three, which one is feeling comfortable?
Second or third?
Very size similar idea both. Third one is comfortable, three, yeah? என்ன பண்ணணும், யூ ஷுட் அப்ளை மெட்ரிக் டு வொர்க் இன் ஆர்டர் டு எஃபெக்டிவ்லி வொர்க் ஆன் இட், இன் ஆர்டர் டு ஆன்சர் இட் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் தட் யூ கேன் நாட் டு இட், யூ ஷுட் அப்ளை மெட்ரிக் ஆன் இட். சின்னதாக ஒரு சின்ன சின்ன வேல்யூஸ் போட்டு பார்ப்போமா. வாட் ஐ எம் டூயிங், ஐ எம் அஸ்யூமிங் சம் மெட்ரிக்ஸ் ஹியர், ரைட். வாட் ஐ சே, ஐ இனிஷியலி அஸ்யூம் 1000 டப்பிள்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் இன் தி எம்ப்ளாய் ரிலேஷன். மை எம்ப்ளாய் ரிலேஷன் ஹஸ் காட் 1000 டப்பிள்ஸ். 1000 டப்பிள்ஸ் என்ன அர்த்தம்? 1000 attributes of dollars. 1000 tuples means 1000 crores. 50 tuples are there in department relation. And out of 1000 tuples, 50 employees are supposed to be managers. And out of 50 tuples, 5 separate sales department exist. This is the another metric to assume money. Right? Assuming this as a metric, I am to work for all these three queries that I have mentioned. Let us see how much it was really for optimization. Right? I'm taking my first query. What is my first query? Select all this from the partition product done between job and department, employee and department. Okay. What it will do initially is to understand employee, what has been done? To understand employee, I may have to scan the entire record that is available to the employee initially, isn't it? Employee, how many relations are there? How many rows are there? How many tuples are there? 1000 tuples. It will scan down all the 1000 tuples before I am going to perform for some operation. Okay? So it scans for 1000 tuples here. At the same time, on the other end, I have 50 tuples. So 1050, initial processing without doing anything is done. Please carefully understand. Sir, Andhra basically, please do understand it very carefully. 1000 initial study of how many tuples are there in employee relation and with department relation, how many tuples exist. 1050 initial, read-only operations are performed, right? So now I do a Cartesian product between employee and department. Multiply put in the rows. One row of the employee multiplied with all the 50 rows of department. How many intermediate relations will be created? Because just of this table, how many relations will be created? 50,000 records. 50,000 records, right? Already I have done a read-only of how many records? 1,050. Now that I insert 50,000 records. Even after 50,000 records, my processing is not complete. Why? Because I have to check for my constraints here. Correct? My constraints are union, union. Isn't it? Job should be manager, department should be sales, and the department number should be equal to all at once. All three at once. You cannot test it. One query, one condition. Second query, second condition. Not like that. You will put all three conditions together, whether it satisfies or not, you will find it out. Right? Now that you have created 50,000 intermediary records, your all three conditions will be put for the first record. You try to match whether the first record satisfies the condition. Likewise, how many records should be cleared?
50,000
records. So to get a simple result of listing all managers who are working for sales department, how many records being processed?
50,000.
Not really. 50,000 to find the result. 50,000 as intermediary because of partition product, and 1,050 for just trading. How much totally? 50,000 for this, 50,000 for Cartesian product, 1,050 for read only. What's the word? 1,01,050 records. Right? Think of the time that I have invested for every record, the cost that I have invested for every record. Just assume I am replacing the word 1,01,050 to process work. I am investing 1 rupee per record. I'm investing 1 rupee per record. Although I say for completing a particular product, I wish to invest 200 crores, it is not directly 200 crores will be given. It is this 200 crores which will be invested on each and every person. This person will take as a salary of say 10 lakhs over this period. The other person will take a salary of 20 lakhs over this period. That is how it is summed to 200 crores. Isn't it? Likewise, to get a simple query of this format, I have processed with 1,01,050 records, and now I say each and every record that I do intermediary process, I am investing 1 rupee per record. So how much would I be totally invested? 1,01,050 rupees. Is this query that worth to spend 1,01,050 rupees? The madri or simple query ki 1,01,050 rupees invest panna apichunna. It is the utmost worst activity that I am trying to do. Is it right? So what should be the better or replacement? I look for second. Right? This is what I have been mentioning. For the initial operation, 1000 plus 50 will be taken. For doing the first calculation product, 1000 into 50. And to fetch the result, 1000 to 50. Right? Summing up, I get 1,01,050 records. Isn't it? What happens when I go for second query that I have written? When you say this is optimized, right? This should be less or more. It should be comparatively less. If comparatively less, just like that you cannot say. Right? At this position, as per your engineering, you should be able to say just like 30% it will be reduced. Abdul Sodramari or quantitative value. He let me correct us. You should not say like less. More. You are not defective engineers. Right? Now 30% into the array quadratic, you should have metrics. Right? I am considering the same metric again. Now that I am applying it for the same query. Second query. What does my second query do? I do equi join for employee and department. From that result, I am taking out manager and sales. Is that okay? So, this process is done. The same initial read should have been done. Employee 1000 records should have been scanned. Department 50 records should have been scanned. So, there is no difference between that. But is Cartesian product effective enough, or is join effective enough to replace Cartesian product? Right? Is join effective enough to replace Cartesian product? Say an answer of a sum. It should be yes. Is it right? How much? That's my question. By how much? Right? I look for all the 1000 tuples on my left hand side of my employee table. Now that I compare employee's department number should be equal to department number, the 50 tuples. That's it. Right? The resultant will be whatever that has been listed on my left hand side. 1,000 tuples would generally would have been scanned, right? So out of this employee joint department, only 1,000 tuples would have been studied, right? Now to retrieve a result of selecting a job manager and name sales, right? That will be performed not as previously we were working with 50,000 records. Now that it got replaced by 20,000, right? It will search within that 1,000. Sariya? Ipa how many records I have scanned? Notebook avachi marikira alavula thookavaru. Yes. 1000 plus 1000 plus 1000 plus 1000 plus. Come on. Are you following? What does my first initial read operation do? It scans for 1000 records, it scans for 50 records. Right? So 1050 is done. After performing my joint operation, only 1000 records fetched. Now it has become 2050. From this 1000, I am supposed to retrieve, I am supposed to select job as manager and department as sales. So totally how much? 3050. Isn't it? From a range of 1,01,050, I have come down to 3,000. Convert that into rupees again. Now we are easier for you. For the same query, I have been investing 1,01,050 for my previous query. Now that got converted to? Which one is appreciable? Isn't it? We are feeling very good because how much it has got reduced? How much percentage? How much percentage? 70%. 75%. 80%. See, parallel, edo or value. 1/30th of its rate. 1/30th of its rate. Apollo Gorchstop. Correct? Right. I am feeling very comfortable. From 1 lakh I have reduced to thousands, few thousands. Right? I am feeling very great. But even though you could reduce it to this level, after your graduation, if you could reduce to this level, it is very much appreciable. That is why as engineers you are being employed to software companies. Because they wanted a lot of optimization to be done. Right? At times we used to talk about lines of code in our company, isn't it? When you talk about companies' practices, every line of code you write, your product will be assessed based on the number of lines of code. Right? Number of lines of code, LOC zone. Right? For small projects, it will be like, Ungrode lab project, and you make Ungrode lab works for finding a, numbers on the quadratic equation, for finding out Fibonacci series. Right? Now, Fibonacci series, right? It will be like, 10s or 20s, 30s, 40s, number of lines of code. But when you look at really the products, it will be going in thousands. It will be called KLOC. Kilo lines of code. Kilo is 1000, isn't it? Kilo lines of code. Right? Adema is a control protocol. Okay? So whenever we are working on a simple project, right? Kilo lines of code, this impacts a lot. Optimization plays a vital role. I will not be investing saying for this program of this kind I will be writing minimum 1 lakh lines of code. 1 lakh rupees pay for it will be dependent on the functionality being provided. Right? It is dependent on functionality being provided. Say for example, how did you choose Welltech engineering colleges when you came for counseling? You would have got n number of reasons. N number of reasons. N number of reasons. Where are you? Yes. Very good place. Yes. Functionality, isn't it? Ultimate goal of yours, at the end of 4 years, I may have to get placed. Right? With a very good CGPA. Because at times I may switch to higher education also. You have entered this particular college. Right? You look at the placement record of this college. So it is reasonably good. Or it is too good. Actually, enter. These are the functional metrics. Right? You look for some metric out of these optimization methods. Okay? We'll work on the third metric, third problem, which says I will select from employee only managers. I will select from department only sales. Right? Now then I try to combine these two.